Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this particular episode, we'll be looking at generative synthesis. The type of generative synthesis we're going to focus on is inspired by the generative dynamic synthesis processes advocated by Xenakis in his book Formalized Music. Today we'll just be looking at the generative elements of those, and we'll leave the dynamic elements to a later episode. This diagram outlines the basic principle of Xenakis's synthesis theory, and that is to identify points that can be joined together to make a waveform. And we'll show a way in which we can manipulate the location of these points, and that will change the waveform. So, to begin, we're going to start with an array. This array is going to hold those points that we're talking about in the waveform. So I'm going to call it points. We'll just use a maximum of 10 points for this, and we'll leave it as points. Everything else is default. So we have our normal range by default in the array, and it's from positive 1 to negative 1. And you'll see that each of those 10 elements in this array can be moved by drawing on them. We've seen that we can draw on arrays before. So we'll create a waveform which joins these points together and goes around and around and around as an oscillation over those points, and that will be our waveform. So the object we need to use to read this wave is the tab read object. We need to pass it the name of the points of the array rather that we're going to read. So to show how this works, if we put a number box on the outside. Oh, actually, no, a number box won't work because we're sending tab read without the tilde, Andrew. Let's try that again. So we get the output and the input. Tab read without the tilde because these are data points, they're not audio. So as we change numbers in this top number box, it reads the element of the array and puts out the value, and that's going to be the basis for the way in which we read through the array and get the value of those locations for our waveform. What we're going to do also, another part of the sort of architecture of what we're looking at doing, is we're going to pass these values into a V-line object, which is going to output a ramp, an audio ramp, because it's an audio object, between each of these values. And so it's this ramp between these values which is going to form our array. That, of course, will need to go through some kind of volume control. Just put a value for that there for the minute, so that when we need it, we've got it. Go out to the DAC as a final outlet, like so. So this is the basis of it. We get our points, we turn them into lines, and then we send them out to the DAC. We need to make this get into the audio range, we need to be able to read through this pretty fast, and me going up and down with a mouse is not going to be anywhere near fast enough. So we're going to need a way of reading through these arrays much quicker than that. I'll leave all that there. I'm going to use a metronome, to automate the process of reading this. We can do this and specify a rate speed, if you like, for our metronome here. And we can also add a toggle to turn our metronome on and off. Just to remind you about metronome, if we have the speed not too fast, every half a second or so, turn it on, we get this series of bangs. What we'll need to do is to count those bangs as they go. So I'm going to remove that for the minute. And we'll implement a counter. To do a counter in PD, we follow this pattern. We have a number box. In this case, it's capable of storing floating point numbers. And we also have an incrementer, just add one to it. So the normal process of creating a counter is to do this kind of process where the bang actions the float, sends the number, the current number out. That current number is added to by one, and then that feeds its way back in and is stored in the number box, so that every time around this loop we get a number which is one greater than it was before. If I put a number box out here and start the metronome, you'll see how that operates, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And that, of course, is running at the pace of our metronome. So that's how that would normally work. In our case, we want to be able to read through this array. And there are 10 elements in it, so it'll be from 0 through to 9. And then we want that to loop back to the beginning. In order to get the looping back, after it's added a number, I'm going to check to see whether or not it needs to go back to the start. This mod is a division, but it provides the remainder of a division. So if we, that can go there and back in here. And now if I put number box back, if we do this and run it again, you'll see that the numbers will run from 0 up to 9, and then the mod operator returns the number that comes out of here back to 0 again. So this is what we require. So we can pass that number into the tab read, and you can see that we're getting a readout of the points. All right, so far so good. And this pretty much will get us to the point we need, except that we don't really have a time between these, except the time for this metro. And I guess at this rate, it's going to be pretty slow. What we might do is we might try and make that work for the minute. Turn the volume up a little bit. But we'll need our metro rate to be much, much, much faster. So I'm going to bring that down. Okay. So we have it running. We've got our oscilloscope doing its thing. As we move around here, it's happening. The jacket to both sides. So we can hear that we're able to change the quality of the sound. And we can draw a new waveform. Quiet waveform, or louder, or aggressive waveform. And this is, this process here is the basis for our generative synthesis. We can make it slightly more interesting, because at the moment we're changing our frequency by changing our metronome speed, but it's pretty coarse, as you can hear. So we want to be able to do something a bit more nuanced. I'm going to put a slider in so that we can control our metro speed, change the properties of that. We'll go from 0 up to about 5 milliseconds. It's going to be down in this lower range where most of the frequency is going to be. So I'm going to change this from being a linear to a logarithmic parameter. We can probably make that go from lower. So when I then use that, I Okay, so our metronome now is running at a much faster rate, 0.1 of a millisecond between reeds. And again, we can change the timbre and change the frequency. But if you look carefully, I'll put this down. If you look carefully at the waveforms, you'll see that at the moment they're all stepped. So they look pretty much like they do here. In the original Generative Synthesis model by Xenakis, he had them being linear ramps between that. So let's look at the process of creating that. What we need to do in order to make them ramps rather than steps is to pass the V-line a duration for which the line should go. At the moment, there's no duration being passed, so it assumes that it's one. So we need to pass two numbers. If you recall, a V-line can take a couple of arguments, and I'm going to make them variables. The first argument is the destination, and the second argument is the duration in milliseconds that it takes to get to that duration. So I've called them $1 and $2 because they're both going to be arguments that are passed in. In order to pass two arguments in, we need to use a pack object, which will pack together two numbers and pass them as out the one outlet. The first number that we want to pack is this number that's coming from the points, and the second number we want is the duration from this slider up here. So now, you can see on our oscilloscope that we've got straight lines between our points instead of steps, and you can hear that that reduces the upper frequency components quite a lot. We get a more mellow kind of sound. We can still get kind of square wavy sound by manipulating our points, but now we've got a much wider range of timbres. Hear that that timbre is consistent even whilst we change our frequency up here, and we can mess with that. So this is a process for generating a waveform, which is why we refer to it as generative synthesis. I'll see you in the next video.